Good afternoon. Welcome to Daily Currency Update from the Currency Desk. On the week ended 23rd of March 2013, we saw the Indian rupee post weekly losses, but at the same time on the last trading day of the week, we saw the Indian rupee cover up the losses to quite a great extent intraday. We had a deadline for the Cyprus bailout proposal. And based on that deadline, Cyprus did post a last minute bailout proposal, which was accepted. And on this sentiments, we had a rally globally on all risk on assets. Also, today in the morning session, we had a positive opening for the Indian rupee, which was also supported by the fact that the Indian government has decided to allow foreign investors in the debt market freely. So this is again another major positive for the dollar inflows into the country. After the dull volumes in the current month for the past 2-3 weeks, we expect the volumes to pick up again in the next week. Though this week there are a lot of holidays and we would not see any major movement except for intraday or based on the international news. At current levels, we see the INR gain up till 53.80 levels in the spot. Coming to euro, yes, the euro rallied from the near term lows to a great extent based on the Cyprus bailout agreement. On the Cyprus bailout deal, they have decided to close their second largest bank, and based on this, all the uninsured deposits which value up to 4.5 billion euros have all been eroded, and they have all been being used to fund the bailout. Again, all insured deposits above 1 lakh euros or 100,000 euros have all been reinstated and transferred to other banks. So basically, market has accepted this model, and as the bailout package has been accepted, currently we are seeing the euro rally up till 1.3 levels, though above 1.3 level is not expected to sustain. So this is like a very good opportunity to sell on. Today there is no data on the European front, but yes, in the coming week, the data coming in from the European front could show us a lot of movement, especially on the downside. If we see any negative data, it would very well be a very good opportunity to short. Currently, coming to pound, it has also rallied on the global risk on sentiments, and based on this rally, we are seeing the pound at near term highs, almost a month high against the Indian rupee and against all the global forex majors. Currently, there are talks about the UK downgrade by the Fitch, but yes, that would be implemented by the end of April, so there is no major scare there on. But yes, the upside for the pound would definitely be capped due to this. We can expect the pound to rally up to 83.30 levels in the spot, and from there on it makes a good sell for the pound against the Indian rupee. Coming to Japanese yen, there is no major news on the Japanese front. There is a testimony expected from the new Bank of Japan Governor Kuroda, and based on this we could see slight movement in the Japanese yen against the Indian rupee. But yes, overall Japan, after the bailout package has been accepted from the Cyprus end, we have seen lot of weakness in the Japanese yen. But no major movement can be expected till the first week of April, wherein we have the first policy meet of the new Bank of Japan governor, wherein we would actually realize what is his stance and what aggressive easing would he take up. Currently, we recommend a hold short with a near term stop loss of 59.20 in the spot. Thank you.